Hi everybody, welcome back to Pop Square. My name is Bill. We're just a few days away from the weekend, so hang there a little bit longer. So if this is your first time joining the stream, welcome, welcome. What I do in the live stream is go over what's going on in the K-pop world. So what can you be anticipating and what can you be looking forward to? So there's quite a few news today, but before I go anywhere into the news, I want to say 생일축하합니다, Soomin from Card. It is her birthday today, so woo! Happy birthday! I want to let you all know that we are actually collaborating together with a Card fan site on Twitter called Card Canada, and we're hosting, or they exactly are hosting, an amazing giveaway where fans can actually be a winner. So two winners will be selected to receive Ride on the Wind, their mini album. So if you enter in, the details are right here, but of course the link will be down there below in the description for you all to check out. The giveaway is going on for 2 weeks long. It's very easy to enter. All you really need to have is a Twitter account. So go over there, sign up, well not sign up, but like participate and see if you're gonna be one of the lucky winners. So of course, again, details will be found in the description down below. And good luck to everybody who enters. It is going on until September 3rd. Two winners will be chosen because there are going to be two mini albums given away. So good luck to everybody. And once again, 생일축하합니다, Soomin. I hope you have a wonderful birthday. Okay, let's go over into today's news. Starting off with Bangtan. So their comeback is just 2 days away for the repackaged album Love Yourself Answer. So to help fans continue getting ready for their comeback, they actually took fans behind the scenes on Bangtan TV, which was the YouTube channel, again, that just had recently hit over 10 million subscribers, so they had won the Diamond Creator Play button. But BTS, they did take their fans behind the scenes to show all the fans the album shooting. So I want to take you all backstage with BTS to show you a quick portion of the album shoot right here. What I really love about watching the album jacket shoot from behind the scenes is because you get to really see how everything kind of goes down and get to see the members just, you know, going through the photo shoot, but also see them being their fun, quirky selves, as we all know and love. But for me, the biggest thing that stood out was in the first shoot, I believe it's Concept S, you do see them in like that red box, and there's some hands going in there. So I mean, I probably should have thought better, but I actually thought that they took a lot of staff members and put their hand in the box, but no, Epiphany, which is like their kind, you know, sorry, not funny, but I literally thought that there was hands going in that box, but no, if you actually watch the full behind the scenes jacket shoot, you do see that they actually had like, you know, mannequin hands in there. So nobody's just like sticking their arm in there like this, you know, just waiting in there for the photo shoot to be done. It actually did create a box that has those hands sticking on there for that concept shoot. And it seems like they did have a lot of fun. But the other one I had to notice was, I believe it's from Concept E, their really big bubble. So I think you might hear Namjoon kind of call it like a snow globe, but I literally thought they were in a fishbowl. Like, you know when you get a goldfish from like Petco or from like a pet store, the iconic image you see is a really big fishbowl and you have a little goldfish swimming around. So I literally thought that BTS was just like really big, you know, goldfish swimming around or sitting around in a big fishbowl. And then some other people even kind of call it like the hamster ball, like the really big hamster ball that people have done some like events in, like where they literally just like run and like go run down a hill. But either way, I really did love watching the album jacket shoot behind the scenes. So again, you're gonna see them be their fun and quirky selves. And I really thought that there might be teasing fans of what song may be playing in the background, but you do get to hear So What be playing. It has been one of the songs in their previous albums. But again, their comeback is in 2 days on August. I almost said October, but no. On August 24th is when the repackaged album will officially be released, and that's when their comeback is going to be. Are you excited? Which version did you get for the album? So again, I decided to go with random and let whichever the world you know, decides to grant me in the BTS ARMY fandom world, whichever one they decide to grant me, I'll be happy with whatever album I'm going to be receiving. And once that comes, I'll be sure to share with you all on which one I got. And of course, I'm very excited to see what photo card I'll be getting. But again, are you excited for BTS's comeback? And are you going to be attending their world tour? Because this is supposed to be kicking off before their world tour begins. So as I said before, please have a lot of fun if you're going to the concert and the tour, but also please be sure to stay safe and just have a lot of fun with BTS and other ARMY fandom members. Okay, now going over to more comebacks, we're gonna go over into September. So Sunmi, remember I mentioned that she has started releasing out some teasers here and there in regard towards her September comeback, and that's on September 4th. So the first photo we had, it said, warning. But now, what falls after warning, you hear some sirens. So now we have a new teaser photo and it says siren. And again, you're not getting much of like a concept photo, but I'm kind of actually wondering if these are going to be song titles in this comeback. Will it be warning and siren? Or do you think she's just trolling all of us and it turns out to be something completely different? But again, I'm very excited to see Sunmi. What is she going to have this time around for her comeback? Because we had the iconic Gashina, Heroin, and then now we're gonna have a new song. So Sunmi, I'm very excited for your comeback, and of course more teasers will be dropping very very soon, because literally next week, roughly around next week or the following week after, you will have Sunmi officially back with her new songs. And then continuing on for September, you have the boys, the boy group The Boys. They're gonna have their comeback and it's gonna be their first ever single album. So their comeback is on September 5th, one day right after Sunmi. So again, it's the first single album. The album title track is called The Sphere. And the title, okay wait, rewind a little second. So the album title is called The Sphere and the title track for The Sphere is called Right Here. So the biggest thing that fans have been really worried about and wondering is if it's going to be a full member group comeback. So remember I mentioned that member Hwa, he had actually decided to, you know, take some time back from doing the promotions because he just recently had received surgery earlier in the year for his leg. And now the company actually gave an update in regard towards that. They're happy to announce that it will be a full member group comeback. So originally for Giddy Up, I believe was the most recent song that they had released, it was supposed to be a full member group comeback, but unfortunately since Hwa was still recovering from his surgery, they decided that this is just going to be like a small little like a gift for their fandom before the official big comeback. So now that Hwa is officially fully recovered, it can be confirmed on September 5th that it will be a full group comeback. And not much teasers are out right now other than the album cover, or like not an album cover, but like the, you know, the concept photo that you see here for The Sphere and the information for the title track called Right Here. So I'm very excited, and again, this is like my first time kind of really being exposed to The Boys. I've seen some of their clips here and there, but now there's going to be a full group comeback. I'm very excited to see what they're going to be having, and I hope that The Boys are really happy that they're finally going to have all their members together, because Paul was kind of featured in the most recent song, but he wasn't participating in the choreography or that much movement because, again, he was waiting for his leg to fully recover, and you wouldn't want the recovery to become undone if by chance he happened to push himself too hard. But the company did give their full statement that yes, he is fully okay and he has been continuing to go to therapy for after the surgery, so he's doing very very well, is making a fast recovery. So but as always, Paul, please be sure to take care of yourselves, and for all the other members and The Boys, we look forward to your comeback. Woo! Okay, now going over to Girls in the Park, GWSN. So again, their comeback is not here yet because they're gonna have their debut. Their debut is gonna be the same day as The Boys' comeback, which is September 5th. So at this time, more teasers are released. So if you follow on their timeline, you see that there are subunit photos going to be released, and then followed by that will be their track list. So the final subunit for Moon is out at this time. So you see photos for Soso, An, and also Minju. So you do see their photos here, and the next photos are going to be released very very soon for the next subunit, which is called Sun. And I'm very excited again because this is going to be the first time you get to actually see this new girl group, Girls in the Park, GWSN, and this is going to be their debut album, and it is called The Park in the Night Part 1. So I'm very excited because again, this is supposed to be a multicultural girl group featuring Japan, China, and Korea. So I'm very excited to see what are they going to be bringing to the K-pop world. And I still can't really tell what kind of genre they're going for because, again, they do say picture says a thousand words. So they could be having this kind of strong image, but they're going for like a ballad song, or they're going to go for like a rock genre, hip-hop. We shall wait and see. Again, not too far away because that's on September 5th. And the last news I want to share with you guys in regarding towards comebacks is a girl group, Oh My Girl. So their company had released out a statement that says the music video for their comeback is officially done. And before we had heard from their subunit, Oh My Girl, Bahana, but now it'll be the full member group. So the last time we have seen from all members in a full group Oh My Girl comeback was in January for Secret Garden. But now we're going to have the entire group coming back in September. Details in regard to us when the music video is going to be released, the comeback date, and everything like that is not out yet. Other than that, it is confirmed they're going to have a comeback in September and that the music video is officially done being filmed right now. Okay, everybody, so that is it for today's news. Thank you, as always, for joining me on the stream. Please be sure to go over to popsquarek.com, go sign up on our community for a free account to be chatting along with everybody in our community, to talk about your love about K-pop, or just really take a time to really learn about more if you have not heard about these groups, these songs, or these things that are going on in the news before. And be assured that we'll be giving you more updates regarding terms of what's happening in the K-pop world if you join us on the stream, but also on our community site. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining me. I'll see you all next time.